Der Stuart hat mir gerade noch eine tolle Story erzählt und ich glaube, das könnte euch auch interessieren. Stuart, can you tell it again, please? Yeah.
Well, it was in the, let's see when this would have been, in the mid-80s, I was doing an album with Elton John. And it was around about the time of, the album was actually called Single Man. And Elton John, I don't know, obviously everyone's heard of Elton John and they've probably heard that he's got a bit of a temper. He likes things to go well, and when they're not going well, he can get a little bit upset. I'm sure everyone knows about that. Anyway, all day long in the studio, he'd been saying that he wanted to put down, he had an idea of putting down this instrumental, which was unusual for Elton. Obviously, usually they were vocals. So it got to about midnight, and everyone was leaving the studio, and he suddenly said, oh, I've got to put this this instrumental down. It won't take long. I've been practicing it. I know it. So I put a bit of tape on. I just saw a bit of tape. I put it on. And he went out to the studio. I was with the producer. I wasn't the producer. I was the engineer. And he starts playing. And it's a song called Song for Guy.
Mm-hmm.
And it'd be, a lot of people know. Da, 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 da. And he starts playing the piano. And then after about 30 seconds, he makes a mistake. So he has to start again. I rewind the tape. And da, 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 da. Anyway, this is getting going now, and he keeps making a mistake. He's getting very annoyed, very upset, because he's keeping us back. He's getting annoyed with himself. Elton used to start going red in the face, and he's getting angry now. So we're hoping that he doesn't make a mistake. Anyway, he starts this one take. I'd started the machine, and, da, 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 and after about 3 minutes, he's still playing this. And I look round, and actually it's not a full reel of tape. Because I thought, how long can this thing be?
You know? You're praying.
Yeah, so I'm thinking, well, it can't, how long can it be? 4 minutes? Anyway, 4 minutes, he's still going, da, 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 da. Now I look back, and we've got this much tape. And we're at 30 inches per second. So it could be a problem. Da, 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 da. Now I'm looking round, it's getting smaller and smaller. And now I'm sweating like this. The producer is running down the front of the studio. And I'm going, does he look like he's going to stop? Not really. Da, 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 da. We're thinking, if we run out of tape, and this is the first time he's done a complete tape, we're dead. Mm. We'll have to run away. That would be the only thing.
Leave the studio.
I swear, this is no word of a lie. The last chord finished, and the tape ran out. And that was Song for Guy, which became a number one hit record.
I know the song. I have to sing it.
Yeah, so these are the things. These are the things that can go wrong.
Mm. Yeah, but these days you have so much gigabytes, you can do it again, again. Exactly. But and then you don't have to stress.
No, what stress? I mean, in fact, you know, we didn't even tell him. We were so pleased. We just thanked God that we didn't run out of tape.
When a whole band is playing, everybody feels the stress. He has to make it right.
Yeah. But those are the great times when I call it magic, you know, when magic is being made before your eyes and you're just hoping that you capture that magic on tape. And I think that still that's the way to make great music, is to capture those magic moments.
The moments.
Yeah.
That the spirit comes out of the speakers.
Yeah, that's right.
And you hear it and you feel it. Stuart, thank you.
Brilliant. Thank you.